What happens if your dog goes after the cat and they have a scuffle and it just did not go well? What do you do? It's okay. It's okay. Hey guys. Hey, welcome to another dog vlog. If you're watching this video, you are likely getting ready to introduce your new dog or your new puppy to your cat and you're feeling a little stressed about it, and that's okay. You're in the right spot. In this video, I'm gonna be sharing some of my best tips and tricks on how I introduce my dogs to my cat, especially because I foster so many rescue dogs. And by doing that, that means I have a lot of dogs coming in the house and many of them have never seen a cat before. So I've learned a lot along the way. And then I have some bonus tips at the very end. So be sure to stick around. So let's jump into this video. And if you're new here, don't forget to click that subscribe button. Help me save all the damn dogs. All right, we're jumping in, right? Meow. Step one, ladies and gents, is critical. Actually, all the steps are critical, but step one is setting up at least two safe spaces for your cat to be able to easily retreat to. How I have it set up for my cat, Haven, who is almost 14 years old. We adopted her from a shelter when she was a little under a year old. Fun fact, I've had her the longest of all my pets. She is truly my queen, my heart, my soul. So the two spots I have set up for her, actually have three, but the first spot is in the laundry area. In that laundry area, she can access in via a baby gate. I'll get more on that in a minute. And in there is food, water, litter box, and a scratchy post. So these are all things that she can get to very easily if a dog were to be chasing her. I'll get to that as well. She knows exactly where those things are at. And I'll tell you guys in a moment the tools that I use to make sure that the dogs cannot get in there and that she can, thanks Ben, and that she can get in there safely, easily, whenever she wants. Now, let's get into the nitty gritty. Step two, you're actually bringing the new dog home, whether it's a puppy, a foster dog, or a new dog that you adopted. What I do is I actually place my cat gently into one of her safe spaces and I shut the door. I know I said earlier you want her to be able to get in and out there when she wants. During this introduction time, what I personally do is I put her in the one of her safe spaces that she really likes and I shut the door. When I bring the new puppy or the new dog into the house, my focus is fully on that dog. And I do not let the dog and the cat meet face to face for at least 3 to 5 days. Oftentimes it's a week or two. Some dogs need longer. So what I do is my focus when I bring the new dog in is immediately on the new dog. We work on basic commands such as focus or look at me. I'll tell you why that's important in a moment. Now, keep in mind, even if the dog doesn't run straight to the door where your cat is, your dog can still smell the cat and the cat can smell the dog. They can hear each other. So that kind of scent and smell introduction is starting to happen, but you have the door shut. So the cat is in a place they feel safe and the dog is in the other part of the house bonding with you and there's no chance of any scuffle to happen. After I spend time with the new, hi Finnegan. After I spend time with the new dog for a while, I then put the new dog in a safe space. Maybe that's a crate, maybe that's with my husband, maybe that's in a dedicated dog room like I'm in now, and then I go spend time alone with my cat in her safe space with the door shut. I let her smell me because what is she gonna smell after I've been working with the dog? She's gonna smell the dog, but there's gonna be very minimal threat because the door's gonna be shut and she's gonna be able to physically see that the dog cannot get to her. Oh, and a caveat, I don't know if I made this clear, you wanna make sure that when your cat is put away in the safe space, they have access to fresh food, fresh water, and litter box, of course. So let's go on to the next step, which is often at this point, after a couple days, or maybe even on the first day, your dog will likely approach the door where the cat is on the other side and they'll sniff each other through the door. I allow this to happen, but what I do is instead of just letting the dog charge down the hallway and then sniff at the door and paw at the door and bark at the door, which many times dogs do, not all, but many times they do, I actually allow the dog to go smell the cat through the door and the cat to smell the dog for a few seconds. But before I let the dog get riled up and get excited, I get the dog's attention. Remember earlier in step one, I said I start working on focus and look at me. This is where that is really gonna come in handy because I can get the dog's attention to focus on me when there's a door between the cat and the dog. That's gonna make it easier down the road for when they are meeting face to face. If I need to get the dog's attention, they already know that looking at me when I ask for a focus is much more fun and exciting than the cat. And so how I do that is just redirect with positive reinforcement, high reward, and gently, not physically removing them, but you know, calling their name, using a toy to play with them, using praise, just getting their attention. Maybe you can use treats. These are all ways that eventually they'll learn, like, oh, I'm gonna run down the hall, I'm gonna start pawing at the door, I'm really excited to get the cat, which makes the cat nervous. But what they'll learn is, if I start doing that, oh wait, if I turn around and look at mom, and I'm paying attention to mom instead of that door, I'm gonna get my favorite toy. I'm gonna get a lot of praise and attention. I get to go play with mom, or I get my favorite treat. So it's really important to do that over several days. So they get the chance to smell each other, but they learn that, oh, when I'm not paying attention to the cat, I get a treat. Now, it is time for the cat and the dog to meet face to face. And this is how I do it every time. It works really well for me. And many of you at this point are gonna ask, wait, how do I know when it's the right time? Is it after 1 day? Is it after 10 days? Every dog is different. You have to be your dog and now your cat's advocate to read the body language. What I personally do is, once they get to the point where the dog is not super interested and super engaged with the cat on the other side of that door, and it's more just another room, that is when I know it may start to be time for them to meet. So what I do is I put a baby gate up. That's the tool number one that you guys are gonna need, or at least I use, put a baby gate up between where the cat is and where the dog is. Then I allow the same kind of thing. I let the dog to kind of approach it, as long as they're approaching with some calm energy and not super, super engaged, I allow that to happen. In this stage though, I do have a loose leash on the dog, and all of this obviously happens under supervision, and I usually have my husband around too in case I need extra hands. But I have the baby gate up and the door open, and I don't just open the door all the way. I actually start by opening it an inch, and then maybe the next day I open it 2 inches, and then so forth. Everything is slow, everything is with positive reinforcement, and everything is over time. That's what I have found to be super, super successful. But what I do is, as the dog approaches the baby gate, there's now very minimal barrier between the cat and the dog. So they have a chance to kind of interact, but there's still safety. The reason I have a loose leash is in case the dog tries to jump over the cat or something, I have some way to kind of control it. But again, I never encourage or recommend to physically just yank the leash. You want to keep it loose so that the dog does not feel tension. It's more of just a safety precaution, especially with foster dogs for me. When I bring them in, I don't know them or their background at all, and my cat's safety is my priority. The step after this is when they really get to meet, and again, this could be after weeks, so do not rush this. But what I do is I actually have the dog with me. I have loose leash there just in case I need it, and lots of high value rewards, could be toy or treat or even just my praise. And I have it in an open room. I don't remove that baby gate from my cat's safe spot and let the dog charge in. I don't do that. What I do is I go into the living room and I actually leave the baby gate. The reason I like baby gate is my cat can fit through the slats, but they also make baby gates that have a little door that opens if your cat can't. And what this allows is for the cat to come out when he or she's ready. I do not force it. I do not pick up my cat and go put it in the living room with my dog. I do not do that. I take my dog to the living room, and as soon as the cat decides to enter, I start getting my dog's attention. I do not want the dog to run up to the cat and jump on the cat or play with the cat. I get my dog's attention with, again, basic obedience, treat, praise, toys, things like that. And I do not allow the dog to just jump and pounce on her, because what I want my cat to learn is that, okay, I'm nervous entering this room where the dog is, but I'm not confined. I can easily run back to my safe space because the baby gate is still there and the dog can't get to me. And, oh, look, I'm noticing that when I enter the room, the dog isn't paying attention to me. The dog is paying attention to Rachel. And that makes me feel more safe because I can kind of scope out the area and the cat can kind of get used to the smell and the sounds and the movement of the dog without having the dog in his or her face. What happens if your dog goes after the cat and they have a scuffle and it just did not go well? What do you do? It's okay. It's okay. It's not the end of the world. I've had this happen multiple times. This is why you have a leash as a backup, so you can keep something bad from happening. But what I do is I separate them completely. I don't punish anybody at all. I just take my cat to her safe space, gently and calmly. I spend time with her alone individually so she feels secure and comfortable. I spend some time with my dog alone, separate from her, so he or she feels secure and comfortable. And I wait another day or two and I retry starting at step one and working my way down. That's exactly what I do if something were to go down that you don't want to happen. So a couple tools that really help me, baby gates, especially ones that have a cat door opener. These thing called door buddies, I actually put these on a couple doors in the house so that the dog can't get in, but the cat can safely run in. So if the cat feels the need to retreat, they have a safe space to run into. I also think cat trees are really helpful. One that's tall enough where the cat can get up and the dog can't get to is really helpful. Two of my really close friends, Jay and Adrian, they're known as the two crazy cat ladies. They have a whole line of holistic and natural supplements that you can give to your cats to help during different transitions. One of them that I really like is called Cat Calm. It is linked down below. It's essentially 80 different natural, cat-safe, cat-friendly herbs that you can give to your cat, and this can help calm them before you even bring the dog in or while the dog is in the house, just to avoid too much stress in general. And two pro tips I have for you are to make sure that your dog has had plenty and plenty of physical and mental exercise before you even attempt step one of introducing dogs to cats. The last thing you want to do is have your dog have pent up physical energy or be totally bored, because it's going to be more likely that something negative might happen. And the other pro tip is, if your dog has any resource issues, remove any toys or food bowls from where the cat may be when they're first meeting, so the dog doesn't feel threatened and the cat doesn't feel threatened. I just want you to know that introducing dogs and cats can be a very stressful time. The fact that you're watching this video, the fact that you're here trying to learn, tells me with full confidence that you are going to get to a place where the dog and the cat can live in the same environment. There are rare occasions where the dog has a super high prey drive and it does become a problem. Most times though, and I've fostered dozens and dozens and dozens of rescue dogs, many of which have high prey drives, through lots and lots of training. And of course, you guys can always work with positive reinforcement trainers. I mean, that should be step 1A, really, if you're having problems. But I have found that most times you can get to a point where they can coexist. So I have confidence in you, I believe in you, I am proud of you for trying to make this work. So keep it up. Connect with me on Instagram if you're not already. It's at Rachel Fasaro, or on Facebook at Fasaro's Fosters. I connect with you guys on a really intimate one-to-one level. And if you guys have any questions, like, send them to me. I'm not a professional dog trainer, but I have a lot of experience and I'm happy to share what I know. Let me do Bark Remark of the Day. This is on a video I did recently where I pretended to faint in front of my dogs and I got Finnegan and Bentley's reaction. This comment goes to Kofi Garu, sorry if I said that wrong, who said, "I'm not first, I'm not last, but when I see Rachel Fasaro, I click super fast." I thought that was just adorable. If you guys want to be a part of my shout outs, just be subscribed, click that notification bell, and send some positive comments in the comment section. And then that leads me to my comment challenge. I've been doing these more and more, and I love how often you guys are participating. The comment challenge today is, comment on this video if you have a cat and a dog, and if so, how did the introduction go? Did they get along? Are they still kind of frenemies, or are they best friends? And if you don't have a cat or you don't have a dog, what is something you learned from this video? All right, guys, and I hope that you have a beautiful day. Goodbye.